This episode of SciShow is sponsored by Endel, an app that creates personalized soundscapes to help you focus, relax, and sleep. The first 100 people to click our link in the description will get a 1 week free trial. We've all had that feeling of being so in the zone that time just seems to melt away. It's also known in psychology circles as the flow state. New research published this week in the journal eNeuro shows what's going on in the brain when a team experiences flow. And the researchers say it's totally different from when you're in the zone by yourself and way more intense. Now, researchers have studied flow in teams before, but they always assumed that the parts of the brain in charge of the social or team aspects were separate from the parts governing flow. But this new study revealed that team flow is more than just the sum of its component brains. Researchers had 15 participants play a rhythm-style video game together. The ones where, like, the notes fall towards you and you gotta push the keys when they reach the bottom. Participants were paired off in a couple of ways. In some groups, one person controlled two keys and the other person controlled the other two. Others were still paired but played by themselves with a black screen placed between them so they couldn't see the other person. The idea was that these setups would put either the team or the individual in a state of flow. The study also had a third setup where participants would play as a team, but the audio for the game was scrambled so that it wasn't fun to play and made it really hard to get into the zone, so a team, but no flow. Those setups allowed them to tease apart the brain areas that were responsible for working as a team versus working as a team in flow. All of the players were fitted with caps that would record their brain activity. The researchers saw that the players who were in a team flow state had their own unique pattern of brain activity. Teams had more beta and gamma brain waves in an area called the medial temporal cortex. That area has been linked to cognitive functions like attention, memory, and awareness, and both beta and gamma waves have been linked to focusing your attention on a task. All of which can get players in that state of flow. Individuals experiencing flow had more beta and gamma waves, although not as much as when playing as a team, and they showed a pattern of brain waves similar to what researchers had seen before for people in flow. Plus, the brain activity of teammates in flow actually synced up. The researchers called this a hypercognitive state, which sounds like some kind of superpower, and they think it's a superpower that could be harnessed, say by picking the most effective team based on how their brain patterns match up. And that could make for some pretty powerful matchups from work to sports. In other news, scientists may have found a new way to boost memory and cognition using an already existing drug. But it is not a psychiatric drug. It's usually used to treat constipation. It's just a proof of concept study for now, but it sets researchers up to develop treatments for the memory issues that come as part of conditions like depression or schizophrenia. The research was published this week in the journal Translational Psychiatry and presented at a meeting of the European College of Neuropsychopharmacology. Previous studies have shown that giving rodents drugs that target a particular chemical receptor in the brain called 5-HT4 helps the animals do better on learning and memory tasks. Possibly because activating this receptor leads to more brain cells growing or strengthening their connections in areas like the hippocampus, the brain's memory center. Researchers wanted to test these kinds of drugs out in people, but they were worried about the potential side effects. So instead of trying to create a new drug in the lab, researchers looked to a drug that's already on the market. They chose prucalopride, which works by cranking up those 5-HT4 receptors. And this is actually how it helps with constipation, by activating those same receptors, but in the gut. Researchers gave this drug to 23 participants, while 21 got a placebo. Participants took the drug for 7 days, and on the 6th day, they did a memory task while getting their brain scanned. The task involved picking out images of landscapes and animals that they'd seen before from a bigger set of around 80 pictures. Those who took prucalopride could remember which pictures they'd seen better than the placebo group, picking 81% of the images compared to 76%. And that might have been because the prucalopride group had more activity in the hippocampus overall. The drug also seemed to increase activity in the right angular gyrus, an area involved in recalling memories, particularly personal experiences. It lit up more than in the placebo group when those on the drug saw a picture they knew. These brain areas are often affected in conditions that affect memory, like dementia, but also schizophrenia, depression, and more. Which makes the researchers hopeful that prucalopride could be used to help counter some of the cognitive issues that go along with certain mental illnesses, potentially as part of a targeted treatment approach tailored to the patient. They say that the next step is figuring out the right dose to give patients where it could help them without giving them too many side effects like abdominal pain, headaches, or dizziness. dizziness. Plus, of course, they'll need to see how it interacts with other drugs like antidepressants. Just goes to show that there are solutions out there in places you might least expect. We'll need to wait for researchers to understand more about the potential of this treatment, but in the meantime, there may at least be a way to sleep a little easier. Endel is an app that creates personalized soundscapes to help you focus, relax, and sleep. Sound can really make us feel better, helping us feel safe and comfortable. Endel takes everything we know about sound and combines it with technology. They use the pentatonic scale and pure intonation to produce simple, natural-seeming sounds. Their tech also takes inputs like time of day, weather, heart rate, and location into account when creating your personalized soundscape. The first 100 people to click the link in the description will get a 1-week free trial of Endel, so thank you for checking them out.